Good evening once again.
Dobro večer ponovo.
This is our last evening.
Ovo je naša zadnje večer.
So your torture is almost over.
Tako da vaše mučenje je skoro završeno.
Well, I've titled this one tongue in cheek. Explain a little bit.
Da to kratko objasnimo, to je u stvari na engleskom igra reči. Trump karta je ona najbolja karta koju možete da odigrate, kao što bismo mi rekli kad imate asa u rukavu, znate. Pa to je za njih to, ta Trump karta, ili oni koji znaju njemački Trumpf karta, znači posebna karta koja se može izvući, glavna.
We spent the last week having a look at prophecy and how the United States fits in and the two swords. We spoke about all of those things.
Mi smo proveli vreme razgovarajući u proteklim danima o tome kako se proročanstvo uklapa u sve aktualne događaje i o proročanstvima biblijskim, kako ona objašnjava ovo što se dešava i sve ostalo.
So I was wondering whether this man perhaps could just fill that position which prophecy has consigned to the end times.
Ja sam se pitao da li možda ovaj čovjek može da upravo se uklopi u tu prazninu koja postoji u onome što proročanstva najavljuju u posljednjim vremenima.
In Revelation chapter 13 we read about this sea beast that comes out of the sea.
U Otkrivenju 13. glavi čitamo o ovoj zveri koja izlazi iz mora.
And the reformers all identified it by its features with Rome.
A reformatori su svi po karakternim osobinama, po osobinama ove zveri prepoznali da se tu radi o Rimu.
It's actually a conglomerate beast of all the beasts of Daniel chapter 7.
To je u stvari jedna zver koja se sastoji od svih onih zveri koje imamo u Danilu u 7. glavi.
Which represent the political systems that would sequentially rule over the earth.
A te zveri iz Danila predstavljaju carstva koja su jedno sa drugom vladala na ovoj zemlji.
And the heart of Daniel chapter 7 is the little horn power which has all the attributes of the papacy.
A srce te 7. glave je u stvari mali rog, ta sila malog roga koja ima sve osobine papstva.
And in this conglomerate beast the reformers saw all the attributes of the little horn and the beasts of Daniel and they identified it as the papacy.
A reformatori su u ovoj zveri prepoznali sve te osobine malog roga i tih zveri iz 7. glave Danila i prepoznali su da se tu radi o papstvu.
It has the feet of a bear.
Ima noge jednog medveda.
Which is Medo-Persian.
Što je Medo-Persija.
And Rome has a Medo-Persian system to its church structure.
A Rim ima Medo-Persijski sistem svoje crkvene strukture.
You see, the Medo-Persians worship the god Mitra.
Vidite, Medo-Persijanci su obožavali boga Mitru.
And the churches were organized in what they called Mitreia.
A crkve su bile organizovane onom što su oni zvali Mitreia.
So the leader was called Father.
Tako da vođa se zvao Otac.
And you had different possibilities of organization.
I imali ste različite mogućnosti organizacije.
So Rome has exactly the same system.
A Rim ima potpuno jednak sistem.
The head of a church is called the father.
Poglavar crkve se naziva otac.
And you have different systems. You can be a Dominican, you can be a Jesuit, you can be a Franciscan, you can be a whatever, a Carmelite.
I također imate ove različite sisteme, odnosno redove, znači vi možete u katoličkoj crkvi da budete dominikanac, franjevac, jezuita i tako dalje i tako dalje.
Then it has the body of a leopard.
A onda ima telo leoparda.
And the leopard was identified in Daniel chapter 7 as Greece.
A Leopard je u 7. glavi prepoznat kao grčko carstvo.
So the philosophy of Rome is based on Greek philosophy.
Tako da filozofija o Rimu je zasnovana na grčkoj filozofiji.
The doctrine on immortality is a Greek philosophy.
Doktrina o besmrtnosti duše je grčka filozofija.
They base their morality on the natural law issue, which is Aristotelian.
A oni moralnost zasnivaju na prirodnom zakonu, što potiče od Aristotela.
And then it has the mouth of a lion.
A onda ima usta lava.
Now the lion stood for Babylon.
Babylon je u stvari taj lav u Danilu 7.
And Babylon had mother and child worship.
A Babylon je imao obožavanje majke i deteta.
Ishtar and Tammuz.
Ishtar i Tammuz.
In Egypt it was Horus the child and Isis the goddess.
A u Egiptu je Horus bilo dete, a Isis je bila boginja.
And the whole Babylonian system is incorporated in Roman Catholicism.
I celi taj sistem je bio uključen u rimokatoličkoj crkvi.
So the doctrine for the masses is a Babylonian doctrine.
Tako doktrina za mase široke je vavilonska doktrina.
And then this creature had 10 horns.
A onda ovo biće ima 10 rogova.
And the 10 horns in Daniel 7 represent the kingdoms of Europe.
A ti 10 rogova u Danilu 7 predstavljaju carstva evropska.
And out of them came this other horn which was blasphemous.
A iz njih je proizašao taj drugi rog koji je bio bogohulan.
And that was the Roman system.
A to je bio rimski sistem.
So the Roman Catholic Church has incorporated the best of all the political religious systems over the ages into its final structure, Roman Catholicism.
Tako da Rimokatolička crkva je inkorporisala ono najbolje iz tih religijsko-političkih sistema iz prošlosti u svoj sistem.
And then the prophet saw another beast, an ally of the first beast.
Onda je prorok video drugu zver, saradnika te prve zveri.
And the second beast was going to make an image to the first beast.
A ta druga zver je trebalo da napravi ikonu prvoj zveri.
An image is something that looks like the original.
Znači ikona ili slika je ono što izgleda kao original.
Because if I look in the mirror, I see an image.
Jer ako gledam u ogledalo, ja vidim sliku.
Now the first beast was political, it ruled as a political power.
Prva zver je bila politička jer je vladala kao politička sila.
But it was also a church.
Ali takođe je bila i crkva.
And so it combined the political with the religious.
Tako da je kombinovala političku i religijsku stranu.
And the dragon gave him his authority.
A ždaha mu je dala svoju vlast.
I'm quoting from Revelation word for word.
Doslovno vam citiram iz Otkrivenja.
So the second beast will become like the first beast.
Tako da druga zver će postati kao prva zver.
So in other words, it must combine the political with the religious.
Drugim rečima, treba da kombinuje političko sa religijskim.
And then it will speak like a dragon.
A onda će progovoriti kao aždaha.
Now, how did the first beast speak?
Kako je prva zver govorila?
It was intolerant to religious liberty.
Bila netolerantna prema religijskoj slobodi.
So the second beast must also become intolerant to religious liberty.
Onda i druga zver mora da bude netolerantna prema religijskoj slobodi.
So the first beast in Revelation, if you were to draw it out, would look like that.
Tako da prva zver iz Otkrivenja, ako biste ju nacrtali, bi otprilike ovako izgledala.
And it comes out of the sea, which in biblical comparison is the peoples, the nations, the multitudes. In other words, it comes out of the populated political systems of the world.
I ova zver izlazi iz mora, a u Otkrivenju 17.15 piše da je su vode narodi, plemena, jezici. Dakle, dolazi iz nastanjenih političkih delova sveta.
Just to show you that this is what the reformers believed, here's Wesley's comment on that beast.
Samo da vam pokažem da su reformatori tako verovali, evo Wesleyevog komentara o toj zveri.
And he says, this beast is the Roman papacy.
I on kaže, ova zver je rimsko papstvo.
He says, there's no other power on the whole earth to which the whole text agrees except to the papacy.
I on kaže, ne postoji ni jedna druga sila na planeti koja se uklapa u opis ovog teksta osim papstva.
He explains that the beast is a spiritual, secular power, so it's a combination of church and state.
I on objašnjava da je zver duhovna i svetovna sila, drugim rečima, to je kombinacija crkve i države.
And it is the opposite of the kingdom of Christ, so it's antichrist.
A to je suprotno Hristovom carstvu, prema tome to je antihrist.
It's not just spiritual or ecclesiastical.
Zver nije samo duhovna ili crkvena.
Nor is it just political.
A nije ni samo politička.
It's a mixture.
To je mešavina.
And it has to do with Rome. It sits on the seven hills.
A ima veze sa Rimom. Sedi na sedam brežuljaka.
So it is Catholicism.
To je dakle katolička crkva.
But then in verse 3 we hear that this first beast would be wounded as it seemed, as if it were dead. But it's not really dead. It's just like it is dead.
A onda čitamo da će ta, u trećem stihu, u 13. glave, da će ta zver dobiti ranu smrtnu koja izgleda kao da je smrtna, kao da će ta zver da umre, ali ona nije stvarno mrtva.
But this beast would become alive again.
Ali ova zver će ponovo da oživi.
And the whole world would follow it.
I celi svet će da ju sledi.
Now, when the reformers started exposing the papacy,
a kada su reformatori počeli da razotkrivaju papstvo,
this was a terrible blow to Rome.
To je bio užasan udarac za Rim.
And nation after nation rejected Roman Catholicism.
I nacija za nacijom je počela da odbija rimokatoličku crkvu.
And the political power of Rome was corroded, it was taken away.
A politička moć Rima je bila oduzeta, skrhana.
So it was necessary for them to go underground.
Bilo je onda neophodno da oni odu u podzemlje.
To try and get their power back.
Da bi pokušali da ponovo zadobiju svoju moć.
And in 1798,
i 1798,
Napoleon arrested the Pope and he ended the political power of the Roman Church.
Napoleon je zarobio papu i time je završio političku dominaciju katoličke crkve.
So if a beast is a political system,
tako da ako je zver politički sistem,
then it seems as if this political system received a death wound and it died politically in 1798.
Onda izgleda kao da je taj politički sistem dobio smrtnu ranu i da je politički umro 1798.
But the Bible predicted that the wound would be healed.
Ali Biblija proriče da će se ta rana izlečiti.
And the whole world would go after this system.
A i da će celi svet slediti taj sistem.
And the newspapers in 1929 under Mussolini said the wound is healed.
A novine iz 1929. Za vreme Mussolinija su napisale rana je zaceljena.
Because Rome again became a political system with a political state, the Vatican State.
Jer je Rim ponovo postao politički sistem sa političkom državom, državom Vatikanom.
But in actual fact, while working secretly under their secret societies.
Ali u stvari, oni su radili tajno kroz svoje tajna društva.
They'd actually set up their political power in all the nations that they had lost already.
Oni su već bili pripremili svoju političku poziciju u nacijama koje su bili izgubili.
And this is a terrible verse. He was given power over all nations and all tongues.
I ovo je strašan stih koji kaže da ne bi vlast na svakim kolenom i narodom, jezikom i plemenom.
So according to the text, who has power over your nation?
Prema ovom tekstu, ko ima moć nad vašom nacijom?
Rome?
Rim. Žao mi je.
Rome's got power over you. So says the Bible.
Rim ima vlast nad vama, tako kaže Biblija.
And then the prophet sees another beast, in other words, another political power.
A onda prorok vidi drugu zver, dakle drugu političku silu.
That is like a lamb, but he also speaks like a dragon.
Koja je kao jagnje, ali i govori kao aždaha.
So if he's lamb-like, then he must be a Christian power.
Ako je kao jagnje, mora da bude hrišćanska moć, ili sila, ili država.
There are two aspects, there are two horns.
Imaju dva roga, to su dva aspekta.
Well, if he speaks like a dragon, then the two horns must be working together.
Ako govori kao aždaha, onda opet ta dva roga moraju da rade zajedno.
So he looks like a lamb, he looks like a nice Christian.
On izgleda kao jagnje, kao fin hrišćanin.
But he's actually doing the work of the dragon.
Ali u stvari obavlja posao aždahe.
Now in the previous lectures we saw how the papacy uses the United States as its sword.
U ranijim lekcijama smo videli kako papstvo koristi Sjedinjene Države kao svoj mač.
And this power,
i ova sila,
will make an image.
Će napraviti ikonu ili sliku.
Now that was very strange because the United States Constitution forbids the union of church and state.
Ali to je jako čudno zato što Ustav Sjedinjenih Država zabranjuje spoj crkve i države.
But in order to be an image, it must unite church and state.
Ali da bi bila slika, preslika, mora da ujedini crkvu i državu.
Now, I can tell you that I've been saying just me for 30 years that church and state will come together in the United States because prophecy says so.
Ja mogu reći da sam samo ja već 30 godina govorio ljudima da će se crkva i država u Sjedinjenim Državama ujediniti jer proročanstvo tako kaže.
And people said, you're mad.
A ljudi su rekli, ma ti si lud.
And I said, no, prophecy says so, it'll happen.
A ja sam rekao, ne, proročanstvo tako kaže, to će se desiti.
And then he'll speak like the dragon.
A onda će da progovori kao aždaha.
He'll say to you, you will not do what your conscience says, you will do like I say, or I'll burn you.
Oni će reći, nećeš ti raditi kako ti tvoja savest nalaže, nego kako ti ja kažem, inače ću da te spalim.
Because that's what the first beast did.
Jer to je ono što je radila prva zver.
So those are the two beasts as they unfolded on the stage of history.
Dakle, to su te dve zveri koje su se pojavile na istorijskoj sceni.
Now the second beast had power to give life unto the image of the beast.
A ova druga zver je imala moć da da život ikoni zverinoj.
So it'll be like the first one, church and state will come together, they will dictate conscience.
Dakle, bit će kao prva, bit će crkva i država zajedno i diktirat će vam kako treba da verujete šta treba da vaša savest prihvati.
And then he'll clear his throat and he'll speak like a dragon. You will.
I onda će da pročisti svoje grlo i onda će nam kaže ima da.
But the interesting thing is that he will cause as many as would not worship the image of the beast that they should be killed.
A zanimljiv deo jeste da kaže i da učini da se pobiju koji se god ne poklone ikoni zverima.
So if you don't go along with the system, you are an enemy of the state.
Ako ne sledite ovaj sistem, onda ste državni neprijatelj.
And yesterday I played you a video of Colonel Hammond where he said at the Jesuit College.
A juče sam vam pustio onaj video od Colonel Hammonda koji je na jezuitskom koleđu rekao.
That if you are a true believer, whether you're Muslim or Christian or Marine.
Gde on kaže da ako ste pravi hrišćanin, bez obzira da ste musliman ili hrišćanin ili nešto treće,
you're dangerous.
Vi ste opasni.
And you have to be eliminated. That's what he said.
Treba vas eliminisati. Tako je rekao.
So they're already talking like that.
Oni dakle već pričaju na ovaj način.
And then he would cause small and great, rich and poor, free and bond to receive a mark in their right hand.
I učini sve male i velike, bogate i siromašne, slobodnjake, robove, te im dade žig na desnoj ruci njihovoj ili na čelima njihovim.
And then the Bible says that you are actually paying homage to the first beast, which is to Rome.
A Biblija kaže da na taj način u stvari izražavate poštovanje prvoj zveri, koja je Rim.
In other words, you are obeying a dictate of the Roman Catholic Church contrary to a dictate in the Bible.
Drugim rečima, vi postupate prema onome što nalaže katolička crkva nasuprot onome što Bog kaže u Bibliji.
And we dealt with it yesterday.
I bavili smo se time juče.
Because Rome said, the mark of my ecclesiastical power is that I changed the Sabbath from Saturday to Sunday.
Jer im kaže, žig moje crkvene moći jeste da sam promenio subotu na nedelju.
So what if this power forces everyone to obey the first beast and to deny the Bible?
I šta ako ova sila bude terala svakoga da se poklanja prvoj zveri i da se odrekne onog što piše u Bibliji?
And you can see how it happens.
I možemo da vidimo kako bi se to desilo.
They will say to you, why do you want to keep the Sabbath?
Rekli bi, zašto hoćete da držite subotu?
Everybody is keeping the Sunday, what's the matter with you?
Pa svako drži nedelju, šta je pogrešno s nama?
And you say, but God said so.
A vi kažete, pa Bog je tako rekao.
And they say, why did God say so?
Oni kažu, a gde je to Bog rekao?
Because he created in six days.
Pa zato što je stvarao šest dana.
That's what they'll say to you. Are you crazy?
On će reći, pa jeste poludili.
It didn't take six days, it took millions and millions of years. What bus do you fall from?
Pa nije to trajalo šest dana, to je trajalo milionima godina. Gde si se ti zaludio?
So you are a fundamentalist?
Dakle, ti si fundamentalista?
Well, we'll tell you that you must do this.
Mi ćemo ti reći da moraš ovako.
And you say no, like the three friends of Daniel, no, we will not bow down to your image.
A vi kažete ne, kao ona trojica mladića u knjizi proroka Danila koji su rekli nećemo se pokloniti tvojom ekipu.
They'll say, who do you think is going to help you?
Oni će reći, a šta vi mislite, ko će vama da pomogne?
He will say, I believe Jesus is going to come again with the clouds of heaven and he's going to help me.
I vi kažete, ja verujem da će Isus doći na oblacima nebeskim i da će mi on pomoći.
What are they going to say to you?
A šta će vam oni reći?
Have you gone mad? Are you crazy? Are you a fundamentalist?
Jesi ti stvarno poludio? Jesi ti neki fundamentalista? Šta je pogrešno s tobom?
Are we going to ruin the entire political system of the world because of an idiot like you?
Da, zar ćemo mi da kvarimo politički sistem celog sveta zbog jednog idiota kao što si ti?
Yeah, give me your credit cards. You cannot buy or sell until you get your brain back.
Daj mi tvoje kreditne kartice, ne možeš ni da kupuješ ni da prodaješ sve dok ti se mozak ne bude vratio.
And eventually they will say, you cannot work with this person.
Znači reći, pa ti s ovom osobom uopšte nemoš da sarađuješ.
So you have to, like the man said, eliminate him.
I onda morat ćemo jednostavno, kao što ne čovjek rekao, da ga eliminišemo.
Sunday is our mark of authority, the church is above the Bible and this transference of Sabbath observance is proof of that fact. So says Rome.
Nedelja je žig ili znak naše vlasti, crkva je iznad Biblije i ovo prenošenje svetkovanja subote na nedelju je dokaz te činjenice, tako kaže katolička crkva.
You will do as I say.
Uradit ćeš kako ti kažem.
And I will say, is it right to obey man rather than God?
A ja ću reći, da li je ispravno da slušam više ljude nego Boga?
And they will get just as angry as the Pharisees were.
A oni će se naljutiti isto toliko koliko se naljutili fariseji.
So now we're not arguing about the day anymore.
Sada više ne diskutujemo o danu.
We're arguing about who has authority and who should get worship.
Sada diskutujemo o tome ko ima vlast i koga treba obožavati.
The day is just incidental.
Dan je samo, eto, tu se našao kao područje diskusije.
It's the tool of decision.
To je alatka na osnovu koje se odlučuje.
By keeping it, I say, I believe God and I'll obey him only.
Kada držim taj dan, ja kažem, ja ću služiti Bogu samo njemu.
By keeping the mark of the beast, I say, okay, you're my boss, Pope, I will bow down, which ring must I kiss? The one on the sand, which foot must I kiss?
Ako idemo na ovu drugu stranu sa nedeljom, onda mi slušamo papu i kažemo dobro papa, bit će onako kako ti kažeš, reci mi koji prsten na kojoj ruci da poljubim ili koju nogu da poljubim.
Yes, and you are above the Bible is not important, your word is important, I'll obey you.
I tako je, ti si iznad Biblije, Biblija je ispod, nije to toliko bitno, ja ću tebe da slušam.
You see, it's not a question just of a day, it's a question of authority.
Vidite, nije to pitanje samo dana, pitanje je vlasti, autoriteta.
So Rome tells you straight out. This is Rome speaking.
I Rim će vam reći direktno, ovo je citat od rimske crkve, katoličke crkve.
Most Christians assume that Sunday is the biblical approved day of worship.
Većina hrišćana pretpostavljaju da je nedelja biblijski dan koji ona odobrava za bogosluženje.
The Roman Catholic Church protests. No, 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 it's not. I'll tell you so. It protests.
Rimokatolička crkva protestuje. Ona kaže, ne, 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 ja ću da ti kažem.
It transferred the Christian worship from the biblical Sabbath Saturday to Sunday. They make sure you know which day they're talking about. It's them that wrote the Saturday.
Oni nam kažu da su oni ti koji su preneli hrišćansko bogosluženje sa biblijske subote na nedelju.
And to try to argue that the change was made in the Bible is both dishonest and, here's the important thing, a denial of Catholic authority.
I pokušati da se argumentuje da je promjena urađena u Bibliji je nepošteno, a takođe i odricanje katoličke vlasti i autoriteta. So to je bitan deo.
Protestants, if you want to base your teachings on the Bible, then show it that you believe that by keeping Saturday.
Dakle, protestanti, ako hoćete da stvarno bazirate vaša učenja samo na Bibliji, onda treba da držite subotu.
Now what must I answer Rome?
Šta da odgovorim u Rimu?
If I keep Sunday, what am I saying to Rome?
Ako ja držim nedelju, šta ja kažem Rimu?
You are the authority in my life.
Ti si autoritet i vlast u mom životu.
If I keep Saturday, what am I saying?
A ako držim subotu, šta onda kažem?
God, you are the authority in my life.
Bože, ti si autoritet u mom životu.
Can you see, it's a choice of authority. It's got... The day is incidental.
Ja, vidite sada da je to pitanje autoriteta. Nije to glavno što je dan, nego kome smo poslušni, ko je naš autoritet.
So now, let's have a look at the United States.
Hajde sada da pogledamo Sjedinjene Američke Države.
Can it speak like a dragon?
Da li one mogu da progovore kao ždah?
Can it say to me, you will do as I say and you will worship Rome by doing what Rome says?
Mogu li da mi kažu, ti ćeš da učiniš kako ti ja kažem, ima da pokažeš poštovanje i bogosluženje Rimu?
The Constitution forbids it.
Ustav to zabranjuje.
And you know what? Here was a Roman Catholic president.
Znate šta, ovde je bio jedan rimokatolički predsednik.
He was a naughty man.
On je bio zločast čovjek.
But I respect what he said.
Ali poštujem ono što je rekao.
He said, I believe in an America where the separation of church and state is absolute.
Ja verujem u Ameriku gde je odvajanje crkve i države apsolutno.
When no Catholic prelate would tell the president, should he be Catholic, how to act, and no Protestant minister would tell his parishioners for whom to vote.
Gde nijedan katolički sveštenik neće reći predsedniku, ako bi on bio katolik, kako da deluje, i nijedan protestantski pastor neće reći svojim vernicima za koga da glasaju.
When no church or church school is granted any public fund or political preference.
Gde nijednoj crkvi ili crkvenoj školi se ne daju javna sredstva, javni fondovi ili politička prednost.
Where religion will never become an act of service, a stumbling stone in service.
Gde religija nikada neće postati neka prepreka u vašoj službi.
I believe in an America that is officially neither Catholic, Protestant nor Jewish.
Verujem u Ameriku koja nije službeno ni katolička, ni protestantska, ni jevrejska.
Where the Pope will not tell you what to do.
Da ni papa neće da vam govori šta da radite.
Where no ecclesiastical power will tell you what to do.
Da ni jedna crkvena sila vam neće reći šta da radite.
Where religious liberty is so indivisible that an act against one church is treated as an act against all.
Da je religijska sloboda tako sveobuhvata da delo protiv jedne crkve se posmatra kao delo protiv svih crkava.
Dead.
I ubili su ga.
Interesting.
Zanimljivo.
That's the Constitution of the United States. He stood by it.
To je Ustav Sjedinjenih Država. On je stajao na tim stanovištima Ustava.
And then he went a step too far.
A onda je otišao korak predaleko.
He said Federal Reserve, which is under the control of Rome.
Rekao je federalna rezerva, koja je pod kontrolom Rima.
You will not control my country anymore. We're going to print our own money now again.
Rekao je, nećeš ti više nas kontrolisati, mi ćemo sada sami da štampamo svoj novac.
And then he was dead.
I onda je bio mrtav.
Now, this man over here on this picture is Carol Quigley.
Čovjek na ovoj slici je Carol Quigley.
That's Bill Clinton's favorite professor at Georgetown University. He's a Jesuit.
To je Bill Clintonov omiljeni profesor na Georgetownu univerzitetu. On je jezuita.
Now, what did he say?
Šta je on rekao?
He's talking about the two political parties in America.
On govori o dve političke partije u Americi.
He said they should represent opposed ideas and policies.
On kaže da treba da predstavljaju suprotstavljene ideje i znači policies su kao zakonske predloge
in which the way in which the government rules.
Način kako vlada vlada.
One on the right, one on the left.
Jedna je na desnoj strani, druga na levoj strani.
But that's foolishness. That's just for academics.
Ali to je samo glupost, to je za one koji se bave akademijom.
In fact, the two parties should be almost identical.
U stvari, te dve partije treba budu skoro identične.
So that when you vote, you can throw people out or in.
Tako da kada glasate, možete ljude da ubacite, da izbacite.
But there's no change in policy.
Ali nema promjene u stvarnom držanju i tim odredbama.
In other words, whether you vote for the devil in pink or the devil in blue, you still get the devil.
Drugim rečima, da li ćete glasati za ljubičastog đavola ili za narandžastog đavola, vi ćete uvijek dobiti đavola.
He's the one who also said,
on je također rekao,
that there is a powerful group of people that rule the world.
Da postoji moćna grupa ljudi koji vladaju svetom.
And he is one of them.
A on je jedan od njih.
He said that.
On je to rekao.
So the Jesuits, he said, rule the world.
Tako da je rekao da jezuiti vladaju svetom.
Now let's talk a little bit about Hegelian dialectic.
Ajde nešto kažemo o hegelijanskoj dijalektici.
So there you have the two political parties.
Evo i dve političke partije.
And let's see how Hegelianism works.
Da vidimo kako hegelijanska logika funkcioniše.
It's a framework for guiding thoughts and actions into conflicts that lead to synthetic solutions which can only be introduced once those being manipulated take a side that will advance the predetermined agenda.
To je okvir za upravljanje mislima i delima u konflikt koji vodi ka sintetičkom rešenju koje može biti uvedeno jedan puta kada su oni koji su izmanipulisani zauzmu svoju stranu, što će unaprediti već unapred određenu agendu.
So how does it work?
Kako to onda funkcioniše?
You create a controlled opposition.
Stvorite kontrolisanu opoziciju.
Which creates a problem.
Koja stvara problem.
So you have a problem.
Onda imamo problem.
Then you have a reaction to the problem.
Onda imamo reakciju na taj problem.
And then you have the solution, which is what you actually want.
A onda imate rešenje koje je u stvari ono što ste vi i planirali da bude, što ste hteli.
So if you look at politics in this way, you can get an entirely new picture of what's happening in the world.
Tako da ako politiku posmatrate na ovaj način, onda možete imati jednu potpuno drugačiju sliku šta se dešava u svetu.
I thought it's rather a nice picture of Obama.
Ja sam mislio da ovo je lepa slika od Obame.
So he says Trump is unfit to serve as president.
On kaže ja smatram da je Trump neodgovarajući, nesposoban da bude predsednik.
The economy is in shambles.
Ekonomija je u lošem stanju.
America seems to be losing everywhere in the world.
Izgleda kao da Amerika svuda gubi u svetu.
There's no border security.
Nema sigurnosti na granicama.
Race relations are at an everlasting low.
I odnosi među različitim rasama su na vrlo niskom nivou.
The American flag is in tatters.
Američka zastava je sva iscepana.
Homosexuality and legislation on homosexuality is rampant.
Homoseksualnost i zakonodavstvo vezano za homoseksualnost je isto tako otišlo u lošem smeru.
The whole nation is falling into decay.
Cela nacija propada.
You have created a problem.
Stvorili ste problem.
Now you must create a solution.
A sad morate stvarati rešenje.
Alright.
Dobro.
This man said the future must not belong to those who slander the prophet Islam.
Ovaj čovjek je rekao budućnost ne sme da pripada onima koji vređaju proroka Islama.
He appoints a whole host of Islamic advisors.
On ima celi niz islamskih savjetnika.
They look at his ring and they say, is that an Islamic ring that he's wearing?
I oni gledaju u njegov prsten i kažu, da li je to islamski prsten koji on nosi?
Is he a secret Muslim?
Da li je on potajno muslima?
And the Christians in the country are scared what's happening. Their country is just going down the drain.
I hrišćani su u Americi uplašeni šta je to sa njihovom zemljom, ona nešto ide sve nešto nizbrdo.
And then you throw a few bombs around.
A onda pobacate par bombi okolo.
And you have the Islamic fundamentalists blow up this and create fear and chaos.
I imate islamske fundamentaliste koji stvaraju strah i haos.
What are you doing?
Šta da radite?
Aren't you herding all the Christians into a huddle?
Zar ne uvodite sve hrišćane u jedan tor onako da se zbiju?
Oh, and the morality has gone down the tube.
Jao, i moralnost je sva otišla nizbrdo.
The White House is lit up like a rainbow when same-sex marriage ruling comes through.
Bela kuća je u bojama duge kada se izglasalo homoseksualni brak.
And Obama says this is a breakthrough ruling. This is freedom for the world.
I Obama kaže ovo je napredna odluka, ovo je sloboda za svet.
And the Christians are herded into a tighter huddle.
A hrišćani se još više stisnu jedno s drugoga.
But at the same time he says listen to this man.
Ali isto vreme on kaže slušajte ovog čoveka.
You think, what's going on here?
Vi kažete, šta je ovde?
On the one hand he's doing everything against the Bible, on the other hand he's lifting up the Pope.
On sve radi na suprot Bibliji, a ovamo uzdiže Pap.
And there he greets the masses.
I ovde on pozdravlja mase.
So this creates a cognitive dissonance.
Ovo stvara kognitivnu, intelektualnu disonancu, odnosno podeljenost.
And now you enter into the contest of two ideologies.
A onda ulazimo u nadmetanje dve ideologije.
One that has left Christians frightened and scattered into bundles.
Jednu koja je ostavila hrišćane zbunjene i zgurane u zajedničko krdo.
And you've created a climate of fear against the liberal policies.
I stvorili ste klimu straha prema liberalnim zakonima.
It's time for the synthesis.
Vreme je za sintezu.
Are these two really so different or are they playing a game?
Da li su ovo dvoje toliko različiti ili oni igraju svoju igru?
The cardinal looks very happy.
Kardinal nam izgleda jako srećan.
To think that that is the highest Knight of Malta in the United States of America.
Znate li da je on najviši malteški vitez u Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama?
He's the cardinal of the armed forces.
On je kardinal vojnih snaga.
And one is sitting to his left and one is sitting to his right and they look very happy.
I jedno sedi njemu s jedne strane, levo, drugo s desne i izgledaju jako srećni.
So, are they just two game players in this great drama of life?
Da li su oni samo dvoje igrača u ovoj velikoj drami života?
They want to slaughter each other when they are on the campaign trail and here they can't wait to smile at each other.
U kampanji prosto jedno drugo kolju, a ovde prosto se radosno smehuju jedno drugome.
Now, it's very interesting that every single president that has ever reigned in the United States, they all come from one family.
Veoma je zanimljivo da svi predsjednici koji su vladali Amerikom, svi dolaze iz jedne porodice.
So in actual fact, that they are kings and queens.
Tako da zapravo oni su carevi i carice.
But to you and us, they are called presidents.
Ali za nas, mi ih zovemo predsjednici.
But the Bible isn't fooled by such secrecy.
Ali Bibliju ne možete da prevarite takvom tajanstvenošću.
The Bible talks about the kings of this world.
Biblija govori o carevima ovoga sveta.
It says they are kings.
Kaže, carevi su.
So now if you look at the web pages where they talk about heritage,
tako kad pogledate ove stranice koje govore o poreklu,
this one asks the question, if all presidents are related, which of the 2017 candidates will be the next president?
I ova web stranica kaže, ako su svi predsjednici u srodstvu, koji od 2017. Kandidata će biti sljedeći predsjednik?
Well, in fact, it doesn't matter because both Trump and Hillary Clinton are related to the same family.
U principu nije ni toliko bitno jer i Hillary i Trump su povezani sa istom porodicom.
They're actually cousins a few times removed.
Oni su, znači, u stvari nećaci.
Trump is related through his mother.
Trump je povezan preko svoje majke.
And so they are, the Clintons are related through her father.
A Clintonovi su povezani kroz oca.
And Bill Clinton, of course, was of the same royal bloodline as well.
A Bill Clinton je naravno bio iz te iste carske loze, također.
So this is the other bloodline book. Did you know that all 44 US presidents have carried European royal bloodlines into office?
Ovo je druga knjiga koja se bavi s ovom temom i kaže da li se znaje da svih 44 predsjednika su doneli sa sobom evropsku, carsku lozu, krv u svoju službu.
So including George Washington.
Uključujući George Washingtona.
They've all had royal genes.
Svi su imali carske gene.
And it's interesting that most 42 of the presidents were related to Charlemagne.
A zanimljivo je da 42 predsjednika su bila povezana sa Karlom Velikim.
Now Charlemagne was the one who was crowned emperor of the Roman Holy Empire.
A Karlo Veliki je bio onaj koji je krunisan kao imperator Svetog Rimskog carstva.
And he was crowned by the Pope.
I njega je Papa krunisao.
Do you think these Charlemagnes are also crowned by the Pope secretly?
Da li mislite da su ovi Karli Veliki krunisani također od cara, od pape tajno?
Now what's also interesting is that the TV program The Simpsons.
Zanimljivo je da TV program Simpsonovi
predicted in the year 2000 that Donald Trump would become president.
Su još 2000. Godine predvidjeli da će Trump postati predsjednik.
Oh, by the way, this is not a once-off.
I usput rečeno, to nije jedan puta.
They predicted many, many things.
Oni su predvidjeli mnoge, mnoge stvari.
They predicted various catastrophes.
Predvideli su razne katastrofe.
They predicted the Ebola virus.
Predvideli su Ebola virus.
They seem to know ahead of time what is going to happen on this earth.
Izgleda da znaju napred šta će se desiti na ovoj zemlji.
And did you know that the writers of the Simpsons are all people with mathematical degrees, PhDs in mathematics and philosophy?
Da li ste znali da pisci koji prave Simpsonove su u stvari sve ljudi izuzetno visoko obrazovani sa diplomama iz matematike, sa doktoratima?
And they get paid the highest wages of any of these TV personalities. They get paid millions.
I oni imaju najviše plate od svih tih koji se bave televizijskim programima. Oni dobijaju milione.
And it's almost scary to think how close they get.
I skoro da zastrašuje koliko blizu oni mogu tu da se pojave.
And of course they're totally esoteric.
Naravno, oni su vrlo ezoterični.
And they use all the same symbology as what the Jesuit author uses in its esoteric world.
I koriste iste simbole koje jezuitski red koristi u svom ezoteričnom, odnosno okultnom svetu.
So if you look at the Simpsons, you'll find the signs of the Illuminati.
Tako da kada pogledate simptome, pronaćete znak Iluminata.
You'll see the all-seeing eye.
Vidjet ćete ono svevideće oko.
You'll see all the Masonic symbols.
Vidjet ćete sve te masonske simbole.
And of course, they predicted 9/11.
Naravno, predvideli su i 11. september, one kule blizance.
Also many years before it happened.
I to isto tako mnogo godina prema što se desilo.
So they seem to have an inside edge.
Kao da imaju onako neku unutrašnju informaciju.
It's interesting that the destruction of New York and 9/11, the Twin Towers.
Zanimljivo je da 11. september i to uništenje tih kula blizanaca.
He's also chiseled onto the relief of the Cathedral of St. John the Divine before it happened.
Isklesano na katedrali Svetog
St. John the Divine, the
Svetog Jovana,
biggest cathedral in America.
Božanstvenog najveće katedrale u Americi, to je isklesano još pre nego što se desilo.
Oh, they do terrible things in that cathedral.
Inače, strašne stvari radi u toj katedrali.
They had a female Christ in it with big breasts.
Imali su Hrista predstavljenog kao žensko sa velikim grudima.
They have the feast of the animals where the cows and the pigs come in and they bless all the animals.
Imali su znači da im tu ulaze krave i svinje i oni ih blagosiljaju, to je neki životinski praznik.
So this was the 2000 episode.
Ovo je iz 2000. godine, znači epizoda Simpsonovih.
And I just want you to look at how they depict Hillary Clinton here.
Pogledajte kako opisuju ovde Hillary Clinton.
She's wearing purple.
Nosi ovu boju ljubičastu.
She's wearing this kind of necklace.
Nosi ovakvu ogrlicu.
She speaks under this sign.
Govori ispod ovog znaka.
She has those earrings.
Ima ove naušnice.
And here's the real picture.
I evo ovde stvarne slike.
She has that.
Ima tu ogrlicu.
Necklace, she has earrings.
Ima takve naušnice.
She's wearing purple.
Nosi ljubičasto.
They're pretty good, right?
Prilično su dobre, zar ne?
17 years in advance they say what she will wear.
17 godina unapred kažu nam šta će da nosi.
This is exciting.
Ovo je uzbudljivo.
And there they have Trump.
A evo ovde imaju i Trumpa.
Speaking between the two flags.
Gde govori između dve zastave.
Wearing the red tie and the suit.
Nosi crvenu kravatu i odelo.
So let's look at it. There's their 2000 image.
E da pogledamo, znači ovo je slika iz 2000. godine.
And there's the real one.
Ovde je stvarna slika.
They've even got the little badge. They've got everything.
Imaju čak i ovaj mali badge ovde sa strane. Sve imaju.
These guys are good.
Ovi momci su dobri.
They're like prophets.
Oni su kao proroci.
And Hillary Clinton is saying, oh no, is this one going to be the president?
A Hillary Clinton kaže, o ne, znači ovaj da bude predsjednik.
Well, history is sometimes more fascinating than fact, right?
Istorija je nekada još više fascinantna nego činjenice.
And the National Catholic Reporter,
a nacionalni katolički časopis Reporter,
tells us something about the candidates.
Nam govori nešto o kandidatima.
Now, do you remember what the previous president said, the previous Catholic president, JFK?
A sećate se što najraniji predsjednik katolički rekao, Kennedy?
So the Bible predicts that that philosophy will stop and they will make an image. They will become church and state together.
A Biblija predviđa da će se ta ideologija zaustaviti i da će se izgraditi ikona zveri, da će spojiti crkvu i državu.
So this is how they introduce themselves.
Evo kako se oni predstavljaju.
Five facts on Mike Pence. He's a born-again evangelical Catholic.
Pet činjenica o Mike Pence-u. On je nanovorođeni evangelistički katolik.
Now, if ever there was an oxymoron, that's an oxymoron.
Ako ikada postoje oksimoron, besmislica, to je onda oksimoron.
You must choose, you're either an evangelical or you are a Catholic. But an evangelical Catholic, that's a mixture that's like fire and water. It cannot work.
Ili ste evangelistički hrišćanin, ili ste katolik. Ne možete da pomešate evangelistički hrišćanin, katolik. To je kao da spajate vatru i vodu.
So the media tells you he's a postmodern evangelical Catholic conservative.
Mediji nam kažu da je on postmoderni evangelistički katolički konzervativac.
Now what do they say Trump is?
A šta kažu šta je Trump?
Well, let's have a look what the Washington Post tells us about Trump.
Vidimo šta nam Washington Post govori o Trumpu.
He went to Ivy League school.
Išao u Ivy League school.
He was at the New York Military Academy as a boy.
Bio je na Njujorškoj vojnoj akademiji kao dečak.
And then he went to Fordham University, a Jesuit school.
A onda je otišao na Fordham univerzitet, što je jezuitska škola.
And then he transferred to the University of Pennsylvania.
A onda se prebacio na univerzitet u Pennsylvania,
which by the way is a clandestine Jesuit controlled university as well.
Što je u stvari također univerzitet koji je kontrolisan od strane jezuita.
So he was trained in Jesuit environment.
Tako da je znači obučavan u okolini jezuitskoj.
Okay, so that's what the Washington Post says.
To nam kaže Washington Post.
Now let's have a look at Mike Pence.
Da pogledamo sada Mike Pence.
And according to the interviews,
prema intervjuima,
and he declined to talk about his spiritual evolution on this,
on je odbio da govori o svojem duhovnom razvoju.
He was a Catholic.
On je bio katolik.
In fact, he was an altar boy.
On je bio u stvari onaj dečak što služi kod oltara.
But then he blended his Catholicism with evangelical Protestantism.
A onda je spojio svoje katoličko verovanje sa evangelističkim protestantizmom.
So I'm a born again evangelical Catholic.
Tako on kaže, ja sam nanovorođeni evangelistički katolik.
So Mike Pence was a Catholic altar boy.
Tako da Mike Pence je bio znači katolički dečak koji služi oltaru.
Raised in the Catholic schooling system.
Odgojen u katoličkom školskom sistemu.
And the running mate of Hillary Clinton was Tim Kaine.
A onaj koji je zajedno sa Hillary Clinton se kandidovao kao potpredsjednik je bio Tim Kaine.
So these two should be really be very opposed to each other.
Tako da ova dvojica bi trebalo da budu baš nasuprot jedan drugome.
Now let's look at the Harvard Divinity School. You can't get a better source than that.
Hajde pogledamo u Harvard teološki fakultet. To je najbolji izvor koji možete da dobijete.
Tim Kaine was educated at a Jesuit high school.
Tim Kaine se obrazovao u jezuitskoj srednjoj školi.
and has been influenced throughout his life by Jesuits.
I cijeli svoj život je bio pod utjecajem jezuita.
And Mike Pence.
A Mike Pence?
He's also a born again evangelical Catholic.
Je također nanovo rođen evangelistički katolik.
And they say this is an unusual faith mix.
Oni kažu, ovo je prilično neobična mešavina vera.
They say, I'm not quite sure what Governor Pence intends to affirm a born-again evangelical Catholic.
I kaže, nisam baš siguran šta guverner Pence planira da kaže sa tim nanovorođen evangelistički katolik.
But he considers himself Catholic.
Ali on sebe smatra katolikom.
He went to mass.
Ide na misu.
Worked as a youth minister in a Catholic church.
Radio je kao pastor za mlade u katoličkoj crkvi.
Even thought of becoming a priest.
Čak je razmišljao da postane sveštenik.
And then he had this grace evangelical experience.
I onda je imao ovo iskustvo sa grace evangelističkom crkvom.
Do you know how many famous film stars were actually Catholic priests?
Znate li koliko je poznatih filmskih zvezda bilo koje su bili katolički sveštenici?
And so, you know, maybe this is just very expedient.
Možda je ovo vrlo zgodno.
Because after all, Pope Francis wants unity between evangelicals and Catholics.
Jer na kraju svih krajeva Papa Franjo želi jedinstvo između evangelističke crkve i katoličke crkve.
What can be better than an evangelical Catholic vice president? Isn't that cool?
Šta onda može biti bolje od jednog evangelističko-katoličkog potpredsjednika?
Why? Because division is the work of the father of lies.
Zašto? Zato što je podela delo oca laži.
He's the father of discord.
On je otac nesloge.
And so enter the charismatic movement.
I hajde da uđemo u harizmatski pokret.
Exclusive. Kenneth Copeland lays hands and prays over Donald Trump.
Ekskluzivno. Kenneth Copeland polaže ruke i moli se nad Donaldom Trumpom.
And so the evangelicals came together, Paula White set up the invitation.
Evangelistički hrišćani su došli zajedno. Paula White je poslala poziv.
But then you had all of these important people, Kenneth and Gloria Copeland, Franklin, David Jeremiah, Crouch, Rabbi Kurt Schneider, Bishop Blumer, all these important people, all laying hands on Trump.
I onda imamo sve bitne verske ličnosti, kao što su Kenneth i Gloria Copeland, Franklin, David Jeremiah, Rabin Kurt Schneider i tako dalje, biskup Blumer, koji su položili ruke na Trumpa.
What are they saying to the nation?
Šta oni time govore naciji?
This is our champion.
Ovo je naš šampion.
He must help us.
On mora da nam pomogne.
Obama has given the country to the Muslims.
Obama je dao zemlju muslimanima.
Everything is immorality. The church must come together. My champion must do it.
I nemoralnost i šta ćemo sada, naš šampion to treba da reši.
It's brilliant.
To je briljantno.
Now, what does Donald Trump say he is?
A šta nam Donald Trump kaže, šta je on?
He says, I'm a born again. Are you a born again Christian?
On kaže, na novo rođeni hrišćanin.
He says he's a Presbyterian Protestant, a Sunday church person and a collector of Bibles.
On kaže da je on presbiterijanac i protestant, osoba koja nedeljom ide u crkvu i sakupljač Biblije.
So what could be nicer than a nice Protestant president with a nice Catholic evangelical vice president to whip up the nation and get them to go where Rome wants them to go?
I šta može biti lepše od jednog protestantskog predsjednika i protestantsko-katoličkog potpredsjednika koji će ići u pravcu u kojem Rim želi da ide?
Could you play that for us? You know how to get it. We have it with subtitles. This was the statement that Donald Trump made to the Catholic world.
Catholics are an important part of the American story. America has been strengthened by hard-working Catholics. From New York to California, the Catholic story is truly unique, and it's a great story. From marching for civil rights to educating millions of children, serving the poor and helping define the pro-life movement, clergy and lay Catholics across the country have made countless contributions to the American success and the American success story. Washington politicians have been hostile to the church. They have been hostile to Catholics. They have been hostile to the members of Catholicism. My administration will stand side by side with the American Catholics to promote the values we all share as Christians and Americans. God bless you. God bless the United States of America. We will make America great again.
But isn't that nice? The Protestant reaching out to the Catholics.
Nije li to lijepo kako protestant se prosto otvara prema katolicima?
Now wouldn't it be nice if the Catholic could reach out to the Protestants?
A ne bi li bilo lijepo kada bi katolik sam mogao da se otvori prema protestantima?
Greetings, I'm Governor Mike Pence. You know, it's my honor this year to serve as the Republican nominee for Vice President of the United States with my running mate Donald Trump. I'm grateful to be able to join you if only by videotape, but I'm not sure how they introduce me. The introduction I prefer is pretty short. I'm a Christian, a conservative, and a Republican in that order. And really, it's as a fellow believer that I'm particularly honored to be able to address you today. I know every one of us has our own story about how we came to faith. For me, I was raised in a family where faith was important. Church on Sunday, grace before dinner. But my faith became my own when I made a personal decision to trust Jesus Christ during the spring of my freshman year in college. That night, my heart was literally broken wide, with gratitude and with joy, when I came to realize that what happened on the cross, in some small measure, actually happened for me. And I know all of you in the room share that same passion and that same sense of gratitude for what was done on our behalf. Years later, my faith has been tested, relied on more times than I could possibly count. All I know for sure today is I need him more than ever. And he's really the center of my life and the center of my family's life. You know, God's love really eclipses our failings. And as always, he's been a source of renewal and strengthening for this nation and for people of faith throughout our history. In these troubled times, I believe we stand at a turning point. When those who cherish faith, those who cherish freedom, those who cherish the sanctity of life and all the liberties enshrined in our Constitution should step forward and heed the call to action. I joined Donald Trump on the Republican ticket because I believe he has the right leadership and the right vision to make America great again. President Donald Trump will appoint justices to the Supreme Court who will uphold our Constitution and the rights of the unborn. Donald Trump will also sign into law legislation that will free up the voices of faith all across this country by repealing what's come to be known as the Johnson Amendment. The Johnson Amendment's literally been on the books since the 1950s, and it essentially threatens tax-exempt organizations and churches with losing their tax status if they speak out on important issues facing the nation from the pulpit. Donald Trump and I are both committed to work with renewed Republican majorities in the House and the Senate to repeal the Johnson Amendment once and for all. You know, the truth is that a careful study of American history has shown that the strength of our nation has come from our communities of faith. Throughout our history, it's been the voices of faith that more often than not have driven our nation to a more perfect union. It was the pulpits around the American founding that thundered against the tyranny of King George. It was the pulpits around America that spoke of the evils of slavery and brought an end to the scourge of slavery in America, even through a great civil conflict. And it was voices of faith and communities of faith that transformed our nation through the civil rights movement in our own lifetime, and we're a better nation for it. The choice today for all of us, though, could not be more clear. I've never seen a more dramatic choice in a national election in my lifetime. I truly do believe we're come to a time for choosing. And I think it's a time in the life of our nation when people who cherish life, when people who cherish our liberties, when people who cherish the great traditions that are enshrined in our Constitution should come together and support Donald Trump and our agenda to make America great again. In these troubled times at home and abroad, challenging times for American families, I'd like to encourage you to do one more thing. and that is to bow the head and bend the knee in the days that remain in this election. Pray for our country. But as you do so, please pray as Lincoln said was his prayer. Not so much that God would be on our side, but that we would be, in his words, on God's side. Because I truly do believe in my heart of hearts that what's been true for millennia is still true today. That if his people, who are called by his name, will humble themselves and pray, he'll again do as he's always done throughout the storied history of this nation. He'll hear from heaven, and he'll heal our land. This one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to address you today. May God bless you, your families, this community of faith, your church, and may God continue to bless the United States of America.
Okay. Well, that was a pretty heart-rending speech.
To je onako jedan srcepajući govor.
It was very well written.
Veoma je dobro napisano.
And surely it must have reached the heart of the voting Christian public.
I sigurno da je doseglo srce hrišćanske populacije koja je glasala.
And he promised that Trump would repeal the Johnson Amendment that muzzles pastors.
I on je obećao da će Trump povući Johnsonov amandman koji muči pastore.
So in other words, in the past you couldn't speak on behalf of a candidate from the pulpit.
Drugim rečima, vi ranije niste mogli da govorite u korist kandidata sa propovedonice.
And if you did, you lost your tax free status.
I ako biste to uradili, onda biste izgubili vaš status da ste oslobođeni od poreza.
So in other words, it separated the church from the state.
Drugim rečima, to je odvajalo crkvu i državu.
And JFK said, that's what it should be.
A Kennedy je rekao, tako to treba da bude.
And that's what the Constitution said.
I tako Ustav kaže.
But the Bible said they'll make an image.
Ali Biblija kaže, oni će napraviti ikonu.
So this is what he's doing.
Eto to upravo se dešava.
Let's have a look at his advisory board.
Hajde pogledamo njegovu listu savjetnika.
It's like the who's who of evangelicals.
Mogli smo kažemo ko je ko od tih evangelističkih hrišćana.
It's got all these famous people, James Dobson, Jerry Falwell, Jack Graham.
On ima sve te jako poznate protestante tu.
All of them, Moore, Morris, great evangelical leaders.
Moore, Morris, Graham, svi su oni tu.
And Donald Trump said, I have such tremendous respect and admiration for this group and I look forward to continuing to talk about the issues important to evangelicals and all Americans and the common sense solution I will implement when I'm president, Donald Trump said of his list that included former Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann.
Ja imam tako ogromno poštovanje i divljenje za ovu grupu i ja jedva čekam da nastavim da razgovaram o važnim pitanjima koja su važna za evangelističke hrišćane i za sve Amerikance i za zajednička rešenja i koja ću ja da primenim kada budem predsjednik, rekao Donald Trump, o ovoj listi koja je uključivala raniju ženu iz kongresa Michelle Bachmann.
And these leaders are so excited.
I njegove vođe su tako uzbuđene.
I tune into their television programs.
Odete na taj televizijski program.
And they're saying, at last we have a voice with the president. We will be a Christian nation again.
Mi kažu, konačno mi imamo svoj glas kroz ovog predsjednika. Bićemo ponovo hrišćanska nacija.
And just about everybody on this picture here is in his advisory board.
I u principu svi sa ove ovde slike su, skoro svi su na njegovom savjetničkom odboru.
And many of these were the ones who laid hands on Donald Trump and blessed him.
I mnogi od njih su oni koji su stavili ruku na Donalda Trumpa i koji su ga blagoslovili.
And Pope Francis met televangelist Kenneth Copeland and James Robinson.
I Papa Franjo se sreo sa televangelizatorima, televizijskim evangelizatorima, Kennethom Copelandom i Jamesom Robinsonom.
So they sit on the Trump's advisory board?
Dakle, oni su savjetnici za Trumpa.
And they run to Rome to embrace the Pope and say, oh, you are our shepherd.
I onda otrče do Rima i kažu, o, tamo kažu papi, o, ti si naš pastir.
Do you think they will want to honor the first beast?
Da li smatrate da će želiti da ukažu poštovanje prvoj zveri?
From the Southern Baptist Convention, the super mega church pastor, Jack Graham, he's on the board.
Iz Južne baptističke konvencije, predsjednik i pastor velike crkve Jack Graham, i on je dio tog njihovog saveta.
And Trump, when he had this meeting with these 900 evangelicals,
a kada je Trump imao sastanak sa tih 900 evangelističkih vođa,
he went to the window of the building,
došao je do prozora zgrade,
and he told the evangelical leaders, look down.
I rekao je tim vođama evangelističkim, pogledajte dole.
And he said, you see those people walking on the street?
Vidite li ove ljude dole koji hodaju ulicom?
They have more voice than you have.
Oni imaju više glasa i više se njihov glas utiče nego vaš.
Because they can say just what they want.
Jer oni mogu da kažu šta god žele.
But you, mega leaders, you may not say anything.
A vi velike vođe ne možete da kažete ništa.
That's going to change.
To ima da se promeni.
You are going to have a voice.
Vi ćete imati glas.
Church and state coming together.
Crkva i država dolaze zajedno.
Am I just guessing?
Da li ja to samo na pretpostavljam?
Time magazine.
Time magazine.
Donald Trump vowed to close the gap between church and state.
Donald Trump se zavetovao da će ukloniti tu provaliju, taj jaz između crkve i države.
I'm reading prophecy on the newspaper.
Ja čitam proročanstvo u novinama.
And if you look what happened to religion, he said.
I on je rekao, ako pogledate šta se desilo sa religijom.
Look what's happened to Christianity.
Pogledajte šta se desilo sa hrišćanstvom.
What are we going to do about it?
Šta ćemo da uradimo po tom pitanju?
You have a chance to do something that will be earth-shaking, he said. I literally mean it, earth-shaking. You've got to get your people out to vote.
Vi možete da učinite nešto što će protresti zemlju. Da, mislim doslovno da će protresti zemlju. Treba da odvedete vaš narod da glasa.
You know what, I actually feel sorry for them.
Znate šta? Meni je njih žao.
I don't know whether they know that they are fulfilling prophecy.
Ne znam da li znaju da ispunjavaju proročanstvo.
Or whether they're so hardened that they don't care that they're fulfilling prophecy.
Ili su toliko otvrdili da ih nije ni briga da li ispunjavaju proročanstvo.
I find it interesting that Der Spiegel had this fascinating cover.
Meni je zanimljivo da ovaj nemački časopis Spiegel ima ovu fascinantnu naslovnu stranicu.
And there it says in capitals, das Ende der Welt, wie wir sie kennen.
A ovde piše, das Ende der Welt, wie wir sie kennen, odnosno kraj sveta kako ga mi poznajemo.
But not, that's not the only one. The World in 2017 from The Economist.
To nije jedini časopis. Ovdje imamo svet u 2017. Od strane ovog časopisa Ekonomista.
Now these are the insider elite bankers. This is the Rothschild paper.
A to su insideri, veliki bankari sveta, to su Rothschildi.
Rothschild means red shield.
A Rothschild znači crveni štit.
That's what the Roman soldiers used to wear.
To su nosili rimski vojnici.
And the Jewish encyclopedia say the Rothschilds are the Vatican bankers.
A jevrejska enciklopedija kaže Rothschildovi su Vatikanovi bankari.
So if the Simpson writers know the future, then they must know it too.
Tako da ako pisci Simpsona znaju budućnost, moraju i oni da je znaju.
Let's see what they predict.
Hajde vidimo šta oni predviđaju.
This is their prediction of 2017.
Ovo je njihovo predviđenje za 2017.
Okay, let's have a look.
Hajde malo to pogledamo.
Now, I'm just guessing, okay?
Ja ovde pretpostavljam.
I see through a glass darkly. I don't know everything.
Ja gledam kao kroz staklo, onako malo zatamljeno, ne znam ja baš sve.
But I have half a brain.
Ali imam barem pola mozga.
And I can't speculate, right?
I mogu malo da špekulišem, zar ne?
So don't quote me, I'm just speculating.
Tako nemojte sad da me citirate, ali ja malo špekulišem.
You can call me a conspiracy theorist if you like. I'm totally used to it.
Možete me nazvati onim koji zagovara teoriju zavere, ja sam se i navikao na to.
Number one, they have a tower here.
Pod broj 1 ovde imaju jednu kulu, jedno utvrđenje.
And lightning, which is the symbol, by the way, of Lucifer.
I imaju tu grom, koji je u stvari simbol Lucifera.
Strikes the tower.
Koji udara u utvrđenje, u tu kulu.
And is breaking it apart.
I slama ga na pola.
It looks like there's a church door and something nailed to the church door.
I tu izgleda kao da su tu vrata crkve i kao da je nešto prikucano na ta vrata crkve.
I'm just thinking, could it be Martin Luther's 95 thesis?
Ja samo razmišljam, da li bi to moglo biti onih 95 teza koje je zakucao Martin Luther?
And here you have two groups coming together.
A ovdje imate dve grupe kako se sastaju.
That were formerly kept apart by this Protestant bastion.
Koje su ranije kroz ovo protestantsku utvrdu utvrđenje bile držane odvojene.
Which is being broken apart.
I ta utvrda se slama.
And look at this, Christianity, and this looks like the Soviet Union. Could it be Soviet communism and atheism finally coming together?
I ovde s desne strane vidite ovo hrišćanstvo, krst, jeli? A s druge strane ovo izgleda kao Sovjetski savez, da li bi to moglo biti da Sovjetski savez sa svojim i ateizmom i svojom stranom se spaja sa ovim hrišćanstvom?
Wasn't Putin at the Pope and said to the Pope?
Zar nije Putin bio kod pape i rekao mu?
I so want the Orthodox religion and the papacy to come together. Didn't he say something like that?
I heard so.
Ah.
I rekao je, ja bih tako voleo da se pravoslavlje udruži sa katoličkom crkvom, da budu jedno.
And Donald Trump enthroned as the ruler of the world?
A Donald Trump je postavljen kao da je vladar celog sveta.
And this looks like some form of spider's web.
A ovo izgleda kao neka vrsta paukove mreže.
And could this be the books of the religious systems of the world all trapped in one spider's web?
Da li bi ovo mogli biti religijske knjige sveta koje su sve u jednoj paukovoj mreži?
Together with the ideologies of Egypt and of Greece and of Rome.
Zajedno sa ideologijom Egipta, Grčke i Rima.
Could they all become one?
Da li bi mogli da svi se nekako uduže, postanu jedno?
And what do we have here?
A šta ovde imamo?
This is the hermit card in the tarot cards.
Ovo je ta u tarot kartama karta hermit, pomozite mi.
Na, whatever, who cares?
Nije.
I don't know what this is, but this looks a little bit like the parting of the seas.
Ne znam tešno šta je ovo, ali ovo izgleda kao se more razdvaja.
And this looks like, you know, the United Nations and the powers associated with globalism.
I ovo izgleda kao Ujedinjene nacije i sile koje su ujedinjene sa globalizmom.
And it looks like they're going to come... Gone.
Izgleda kao će ono ići i nestati.
That's very interesting.
Veoma zanimljivo.
And then you have the death card.
A onda imamo kartu smrti.
This looks very bad for 2017.
Ovo mnogo izgleda loše za 2017.
You have all kinds of environmental destruction over here.
Imamo sve vrste uništenja okoliša ovde.
You have a nuclear explosion.
Imamo nuklearnu eksploziju.
And here you have all kinds of insects, perhaps bringing disease. So it's disease, catastrophe and nuclear war. Something like that, I don't know.
I ovde imamo neke insekte koji verovatno donose bolest. Tako da znači imamo ekološku katastrofu, nuklearni rat i bolesti.
And then the magician, he's pushing a button on a 3D program.
A onda imamo mađioničara ili čarobnjaka koji stišće dugme na trodimenzionalnom programu.
So I'm wondering, are they going to use 3D hologram technology to make things happen?
I onda se pitam da li će možda koristiti holograme u tri dimenzije da učine da se nešto uradi, postigne.
He's got the sign of infinity, so he's always existed. Is it a symbol of Lucifer or something like that?
A on ima znak beskonačni, znači on je uvijek bio tu, da li bi to mogo biti znak Lucifera?
And then you have the wheel of fortune over here.
I onda imate točak sreće ovde.
And, well, it looks like here's a ballot box, a voting box.
I ovde izgleda kao da imamo kutiju za glasanje.
And this must be Angela Merkel, because there's the German flag over there.
Ovo mora da je Angela Merkel, jer je tu nemačka zastava.
And here you have the flags of the Netherlands and France.
I ovde imamo zastave Holandije i Francuske.
So, is the ballot box going to decide this year to do the same in Europe as has happened in the United States?
Da li će glasačka kutija u Evropi učiniti da se desi isto u Evropi što se desilo u Americi?
Are the globalists going to lose the election?
Da li će globalisti izgubiti izbore?
And is the world moving in the direction of Trump?
I onda da vidimo da svet ide u pravcu Trumpa.
So, I'm just speculating, okay? Oh, I missed the last one, sorry.
Ja samo spekulišem, okay?
Now, these here are all celebrity stars, but I don't know exactly who they are. They've got faces on them.
A ovo su sve poznate ličnosti koje su u stvari zvezde i ne znam ko su, ali imaju lica.
So they must point to the media somehow. Entertainment, media.
Tako da to kao da upućuje na medije, na industriju zabave i slično.
But there's a comment, so that also points to catastrophe or some spiritual enlightenment.
Ali imamo i kometu što može da upućuje ili na katastrofu ili na neko duhovno prosvetljenje.
So interesting predictions by the elite.
Tako da to su neke zanimljiva predviđanja od strane elite.
So are we heading for a new globalization?
Da li idemo ka novoj globalizaciji?
Obama and Merkel, globalization is here to stay.
Obama i Merkel, globalizacija je tu da ostane.
President Barack Obama and Angela Merkel held a joint conference and they said it's here to stay.
Predsjednik Barack Obama i kancelar Angela Merkel kažu to globalizacija treba da ostane.
So the values and the ideas of globalization are here to stay.
Tako da vrednosti i ideje globalizacije treba da ostanu.
But the tarot card said they're going to drown in the Red Sea.
Ali faraon je rekao da će se utopiti u Crvenom moru.
And here is a newspaper article, EU unraveling patriot versus globalist.
Evropska zajednica nam otkriva patriota nasuprot globaliste.
Many French voters believe that for the first time their candidate can win.
Mnogi francuski glasači su rekli da konačno njihov kandidat može da pobedi.
Is Europe moving in the direction of Donald Trump? That cannot be.
Da li Evropa ide u pravcu Donalda Trumpa? Pa to ne može da bude.
After Clinton, Trump's real enemy is globalism.
Nakon Clintona, Trumpov stvarni neprijatelj je globalizam.
Trump denounced the false song of globalism.
Trump je rekao pogrešna pesma globalizma.
He was going to destroy globalism.
On hoće da uništi globalizam.
Brexit, rejecting globalism.
Brexit, odbijanje globalizma.
So is Europe moving in that direction too?
Da li se Evropa kreće u tom pravcu takođe?
Now it's just a little bit of interesting history.
Evo još malo zanimljive istorije.
There are three independent city states in the world.
Postoje tri nezavisne države, gradovi države u svetu.
They're not subject to the nation, they are independent states.
Oni nisu potčinjeni državi, oni su nezavisni gradovi države.
So they are country cities within cities.
Tako da su oni države, gradovi unutar države.
The one is the city of London.
Jedan je London.
And it has an obelisk which they call Cleopatra's Needle.
I ima obelisk koji zovu Kleopatrina igla.
And then you have the Washington Monument in also in a city state with its needle.
Imamo Washington znači spomenik
takođe
sa svojom iglom i onda imamo Vatikan.
So if we look at the Vatican,
kad posmatramo Vatikan,
it has its own coat of arms.
Ima takođe svoje posebno obeležje i oružje.
And it has an independent state city within Rome.
Ima svoju nezavisnu državu unutar Rima.
That is the heart of the religious power of Rome.
To je srce religijske moći Rima.
This is the one that wears the spiritual sword.
To je ona sila koja maše duhovnim mačem.
And then if you go to the coat of arms of the city of London,
a kada odete do grba i naoružanja Londona.
And there in the city you have here on the right this demarcated area over here. That is the banking sector. It's an independent sovereign state.
Ovo je taj bankarski deo grada i to je potpuno nezavisna država.
It has its own flag and its own coat of arms.
Ima svoju posebnu zastavu i svoj posebni grb.
This is where the world economy is ruled from.
Odatle se vlada svetskom ekonomijom.
It belongs to Rome.
I to pripada Rimu.
It's under the control of the Jesuits and the Knights of Malta.
To je pod kontrolom jezuita i malteških vitezova.
It's the economic powerhouse of Rome.
To je ekonomsko mesto moći Rima.
And then you have the District of Columbia in Washington.
I onda imate distrikt kolumbijski u Vašingtonu,
which is an independent sovereign state and has its own flag.
I to je nezavisna suverena država koja ima svoju zastavu.
And this is the military arm of Rome.
I to je vojna ruka Rima.
Isn't it interesting that there are three?
Zar nije zanimljivo da su tri?
Because they represent the three powers. Just like in the Bible there are three powers, so here there are three powers.
I predstavljaju tri sile, kao što su u Bibliji tri sile i ovde su tri sile.
Because the devil is God's monkey.
Jer đavo je Boži majmun.
He wants to be exactly like God.
On želi da bude upravo kao Bog, tako da ponaša.
Even his spirituality is divided into three.
Tako da je njegova duhovnost podeljena u tri dela.
You have the dragon,
imate žrahu,
the beast,
zver,
and the false prophet.
I lažnog proroka.
And who do they represent?
Koga predstavljaju?
The father,
oca,
the son,
sina,
and the spirit.
I svetog duha.
He's God's monkey. He wants to be like God.
On je Boži majmun. On želi da bude kao Bog.
So here is the very influential magazine Foreign Affairs.
Ovde je vrlo uticajni časopis strana pitanja.
And they say it's the end of globalism.
I oni kažu kraj je globalizma.
So what's going to happen to China now?
Šta će se onda sada desiti sa Kinom?
So they had Brexit.
Imali su Brexit.
And then globalization is running out of steam.
A globalizaciji ponestaje energije.
But who would expect that the top prize would go to the White House so soon? In other words, that the anti-globalists should win so soon.
Ali ko bi očekivao da će u Beloj kući anti-globalisti tako brzo da pobede?
Donald Trump looks out on the world, he sees a landscape of threats to the United States.
Donald Trump posmatra svet i on vidi potencijalne opasnosti za Sjedinjene Države.
Freedom of religion,
sloboda religije.
The world is under serious threat.
Svet je pod ozbiljnom opasnošću.
We have to stop terrorism.
Moramo da zaustavimo terorizam.
Have to end persecution of Christians.
Moramo da zaustavimo progonstvo hrišćana.
And I will totally destroy the Johnson Amendment.
I ja ću totalno da uništim Johnsonov amandman.
And the religious leaders will speak freely of their faith.
A religijske vođe će slobodno da govore o svojoj veri.
That's why he appeals to the evangelicals. They love him.
Zato ga vole evangelistički hrišćani, on ih nekako privlači.
And 94% of Republicans identify with evangelicals.
I 94% republikanaca su se identifikuju sa evangelističkim hrišćanima.
This is fascinating.
Ovo je fascinantno.
The Christian century.
Hrišćanski vek.
The rise and fall and rise of Christian nationalism.
Podizanje i pad i podizanje hrišćanskog nacionalizma.
That's unheard of.
To nikada nije se čulo ranije.
It looked like Christianity was in tatters, was destroyed.
Izgledalo je kao da se hrišćanstvo totalno uništilo, da je...
But now Christian nationalism is rising.
Ali sada se podiže hrišćanski nacionalizam.
Now if you want to rule and you want to force everyone to do what you say,
ako hoćete da vladate i da naterate da svako radi kako vi kažete,
then those old freedoms unfortunately have to go.
Onda te stare slobode moraju da prestanu.
The Bible says he spoke like a dragon.
Biblija kaže progovorio je kao ždaha.
He forced everyone to accept the mark of the beast, to worship the first beast.
On je prisilio svakoga da prihvati žig zverin, da služi zveri, da poštuje zveri.
Now look what Time magazine says. I mean, these are mega insider magazines.
Pogledajte šta Time magazine kaže, to su ti ogromni insajderski magazini.
Donald Trump and the new dawn of tyranny?
Donald Trump i nova zora tiranije?
And look who's writing it. It's a Yale University professor of history.
I pogledajte ko to piše. To je profesor istorije na Yale univerzitetu.
Plato already said
Platon je već rekao
that the final step before tyranny is democracy.
Da konačni korak pre tiranije je demokratija.
So when democracy has to falter, then comes tyranny. There's always a tyrant that rises.
Tako da kada demokratija poklekne, onda uvek mora da se pojavi jedan tiranin.
So they're shouting, is this the rise of tyranny?
Tako da oni viču, da li je ovo podizanje tiranije?
Right-wing authoritarians today use the threat or reality of terrorism to seek a hold on power.
Desničarski autoritativni ljudi danas koriste opasnost ili stvarnost terorizma da bi se držali moć.
So they say, you know, Donald Trump is really threatening the Muslims.
Tako da oni kažu, znate, u stvari, Donald Trump stvarno je pretnja za muslimane.
He's enraging them.
On ih je razbesnio.
He said, I will move the embassy to Jerusalem.
On kaže, ja ću preselim ambasadu u Jerusalim.
So is he inviting terrorism?
Tako da li on poziva terorizam?
So that they can have the reaction that they want and get the tyranny.
Tako da mogu da imaju reakciju koju žele i nametnu tiraniju.
Now this very, very prominent man, Robert Reich.
Ovo je vrlo, vrlo prominentni čovek, Robert Reich.
He says there are 15 warning signs of an impending Trump tyranny.
Kaže, postoje 15 znakova koji opominju na vrlo blisku Trumpovu tiraniju.
And then he lists them over there.
I onda ih ovde nabraja.
And he says Trump does every single one of them.
i kaže da Trump ispunjava svaku pojedinačnu stvar.
He's downplaying the press.
On zanemaruje štampu.
Everybody is an enemy.
Svako je neprijatelj.
They need to consolidate their power and their borders.
Moraju da udruže njihovu moć i da i svoje granice zaštite.
They start with mass deportation.
Počinju sa masovnim deportacijama.
They start appointing many generals to office.
Postavljaju mnoge generale u službu.
Now, who is Robert Reich?
A ko je Robert Reich?
Well, Robert Reich, one of the nation's leading experts on work and the economy, is Chancellor Professor of Public Policy at Goldman School, University of California, and he served in three national administrations, most recently Secretary of Labor under Bill Clinton's presidency. And he was one of the most effective cabinet secretaries. So he's not a fool. He says it's coming.
Ko je dakle Robert Reich? On je jedan od vodećih eksperta po pitanju ekonomije i profesor javnog prava na Goldman School i javnog prava i na Univerzitetu u Kaliforniji. On je služio u tri državne administracije, u zadnjoj pod predsjednikom Bill Clintonom, i on je takođe bio jedan od 10 najefikasnijih sekretara kabineta u zadnjem veku. Dakle, on nije neka budala, on kaže da to dolazi.
Now let me tell you, whatever happens in politics was planned to happen in politics.
Da vam kažem, sve što se dešava u politici je isplanirano da se desi u politici.
Here you have Donald Trump speaking to Congress between the fasciae.
Ovde imate Donalda Trumpa koji govori u kongresu između ovih fašističkih obilježja.
Now what is a fascia?
A šta je to fascia ili fascia?
It's a symbol of fascism.
To je simbol fašizma.
It was the Roman governor's spear.
To je bilo koplje rimskog guvernera.
And all the member states brought their rods and tied it to his spear.
A sve države članice su donele svoje štapove i povezali su ih sa njegovim kopljem.
So all power was in one man.
Tako da je sva moć bila u jednom čovjeku.
And that's how Rome likes to rule.
I to je kako Rim voli da vlada.
One power in religion,
jedna moć u religiji,
one power in politics,
jedna moć u politici.
A pope and an emperor,
papa i imperator.
A pope and an Adolf,
papa i Adolf.
A pope and a Trump,
papa i Trump.
Let's just ask them.
Hajde da ih pitamo.
This is what the journalist Pierre Parson wrote about Catholics.
Ovo je napisao novinar Pierre Parson o katolicima.
For today, Rome considers the fascist regime the nearest to its dogmas and interests.
Za danas, Rim smatra fašistički režim najbliži svojim dogmama i interesima.
And he says, the Reverend Jesuit Father Coughlin praised Mussolini's Italy as a Christian democracy.
Sveštenik, jezuitski sveštenik, otac Coughlin, je hvalio Mussolinija, Mussolinijevu Italiju kao hrišćansku demokratiju.
And Civiltà Cattolica, which is the Jesuit magazine in Rome.
A Civiltà Cattolica, koja je jezuitski časopis u Rimu,
said fascism is the regime that corresponds most closely to the concepts of the Church of Rome.
Je izjavio otvoreno da fašizam je režim koji najbolje odgovara i najbliže konceptima rimske crkve.
Have they been planning fascism for many, many years? Why are the fascii there?
Da li su oni već dugo godina planirali fašizam? Zašto tu imamo tu fašiju?
Isn't it strange that Italy rejected EU and globalism and elected the far right?
Nije li to čudo što Italija odbila EU i globalizam i izabrala krajnju desnicu?
I'm wondering if France and Germany will be next.
Pitam se da li će Francuska i Nemačka biti sledeće.
It might not happen, I'm not a prophet.
Možda se neće desiti, ja nisam prorok.
I'm just reading what these people are saying.
Ali čitam što ovi ljudi kažu.
So France's far-right party say, this is our country, we want it back, not the Muslims, we want it back.
Francuska desničarska partija, krajnja desničarska partija je rekla, ovo je naša zemlja, mi je želimo ne da, da je imaju, da ima islam.
And they want a European day for a work-free Sunday.
I oni žele evropski dan koji će biti slobodan kao, a da to bude neradna nedelja.
Isn't it interesting that all these things are coming at exactly the same time?
Nije li zanimljivo da sve ove stvari se nekako dešavaju isto vreme?
And in America they want the Lord's Day, the Sunday back.
A u Americi žele dan gospodnji, odnosno nedelju, da im se vrati.
We want Sunday back, they say.
Hoćemo da nam se vrati nedelja, kažu.
So in the United States and in Europe, the same voice, the same political movement.
Tako da u Americi i u Evropi isti glas, isti politički pokret.
Sunday is a mark of our Christian unity.
Nedelja je znak našeg hrišćanskog jedinstva.
And then the Pittsburgh Gazette wrote in December 2015 already.
A onda Pittsburgh Gazette je napisao još 2015.
Religion is good for families and kids.
Religija je dobra za porodice i za decu.
We need Sunday back as a day of rest.
Treba nam nedelja da nam se vrati kao dan od odmora.
So what are all those evangelical leaders whispering in Donald Trump's ear?
Tako šta ti evangelističke, te evangelističke vođe šapuću u uho Donalda Trumpa?
Americans deserve a day of rest, a day to be with a family, to attend church, to interact with people. How peaceful that day would be.
Amerika zaslužuje odmor, dan kada ćemo biti sa porodicama, ići u crkvu. Kako bi to bio jedan miran dan?
Is the prophetic picture beginning to fall into place?
Da li proročka slika polako dolazi na svoje mesto?
We must come together. 1 million Christians come to the National Mall.
Moramo da se udružimo. Milion hrišćana neka dođu u veliki nacionalni tržni centar.
That is in that independent part of the sovereign state in Washington.
A to je u toj nezavisnoj državi u Washingtonu.
So there they came together with TED Talks and all kinds of stuff and saying, we want to be a Christian nation again.
I tu su došli svi zajedno sa TED pričom i rekli su, mi želimo ponovo da budemo jedna hrišćanska nacija.
And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed.
I dano joj bi da dade duh ikoni zverinoj, da progovori ikona zverina, da učine da se pobiju koji se god ne poklone ikoni zverinoj.
Now, I'm not saying when.
Ja ne govorim kada će se to desiti.
But I'm saying it will happen.
Ali vam kažem da će se to desiti.
Prophecy says so.
Proročanstvo tako kaže.
It's going to happen.
I to će se desiti.
I don't know whether it's next year or the year after or the year after.
Ja ne znam da će to biti sledeće godine ili godine nakon toga ili godine nakon te godine.
All I'm asking you to consider.
Ali sve što od vas tražim jeste da o tome razmišljate.
Are all the chess pieces in place for it to happen?
Da li su sve šahovske figure na svojem mestu da bi se to moglo desiti?
And if your answer is yes.
A ako je vaš odgovor da.
That means you have a choice to make.
Onda znači da morate da donesete svoj izbor.
Whose side are you on?
Na kojoj strani ćete vi biti?
God's side, where you will be ridiculed and mocked and sentenced to death.
Da li ćete biti na Božoj strani gde će vam se rugati i onda vas čak i progoniti i osuditi na smrt?
Or will you go with the popular religious movements of the world and the political systems to fulfill prophecy?
Ili ćete ići zajedno sa popularnim hrišćanskim i verskim pravcima sveta i na taj način ispuniti proročanstvo.
And the ten horns which thou sawest are ten kings which have received no kingdom as yet, but received power as kings 1 hour with the beast. So the political systems will unite with Catholicism.
I 10 rogova koje si video, to su 10 careva koji carstvo još ne primiše, nego će oblast kao carevi na jedno vreme ili za jedan čas, kao što tamo piše, primiti sa zveri. Dakle, to su ti politički sistemi koji će se udružiti sa papstvom.
And they are kings.
I oni su carevi.
They are royals.
Oni su carskog porekla.
Don't be fooled by their titles of president.
I nemojte da vas prevare naslovi kao što su predsednici.
They have one mind. They shall give their power and strength to the beast.
Oni jednu volju imaju i silu i oblast svoju daće zveri.
They're going to give their power to Rome.
Daće svoju moć Rimu.
They have already done it.
Već su to i učinili.
And then they will make war with the Lamb.
I onda će ratovati sa jagnjetom.
How do you make war against God?
A kako da vodite rat protiv Boga?
By attacking his people.
Napadajući njegov narod.
But there's good news.
Ali postoji dobra vest.
The Lamb shall overcome them, for he is Lord of lords and King of kings, and they that are with him are called, chosen and faithful.
Jagnje će ih pobediti, jer je gospodar nad gospodarima i car nad carevima, i koji su s njim jesu pozvani i izabrani i verni.
Perhaps we shall see each other again on this earth, perhaps we shall not.
Možda ćemo se ponovo vidjeti na ovoj zemlji, a možda nećemo.
Perhaps we shall escape persecution, perhaps we shall not.
Možda ćemo izbeći progonstvo, a možda nećemo.
But whatever happens, the Lamb is going to overcome them.
Ali šta god da se desi, jagnje će ih pobediti.
So whether I see you again on this earth or whether I see you again in heaven,
tako da bez obzira da li ćemo se vidjeti na ovoj zemlji ili ćemo se vidjeti tek na nebu,
it is my prayer that you will all be there.
Moja je molitva da vi svi budete tamo.
And in order to be there, one must make a choice to worship where worship is due.
A da bismo bili tamo, moramo da donesemo izbor da obožavamo onoga kome naše obožavanje pripada.
May God help you.
Neka vam Bog u tome pomogne.
May he strengthen you.
Neka vas ojača.
May he use you.
Neka vas iskoristi.
To warn this entire nation.
Da opomenete ovu celu naciju.
About what is coming.
O tome što dolazi.
May God bless you. Thank you.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi. Hvala vam.